welcome to Stability Before Strength. My name is Oscar and I'll be your host. For previous videos, you can check out the channel. Hey guys, thanks for joining. Welcome to our series on human muscle anatomy. And we're continuing our series on human muscle anatomy of the lower leg with the seventh muscle. Now the seventh muscle is known as the gastrocnemius. So this is the seventh muscle of the extrinsic muscles of the lower leg. And these 12 muscles are divided into four compartments. We've gone over the first two. The first one is called the anterior compartment, and it has four muscles, which one of them is the anterior tibialis. And then the second compartment is called the lateral compartment, and that only has two muscles. And now we're down to the superficial posterior compartment, and that's where the gastrocnemius is found. Now, the other two muscles, because that's three muscles, are in the superficial compartment, are the soleus and plantaris. And then we have the fourth compartment is called the posterior compartment, and it also has three muscles. Now, where and what compartment is the gastrocnemius found? The superficial posterior compartment. And what is the other two muscles of the superficial posterior compartment? The soleus and the plantaris. So, where in your body is the gastrocnemius? Well, the gastrocnemius covers your whole back part of your leg, superficial, so that means it's going to be at the top layer, and it's actually a huge muscle, huge plantarflexor. So we're going to find out where it originates and locate the muscle.
You can see the gastrocnemius muscle covering the majority of the back part of my leg. It has two origins corresponding to its two heads. Now the medial head originates in the medial condyle of the femur, and the lateral head originates in the lateral condyle of the femur. Now the two heads travel down the lower leg and emerge with the soleus muscle to become your Achilles tendon and insert into the mid-posterior calcaneus bone. Now, what will be the action of the gastrocnemius? Since it crosses two joints, the knee and ankle joint, it has two actions, one in the knee and the other one in the ankle joint. The gastrocnemius performs knee flexion and plantar flexion. It is a powerful plantar flexor, and this muscle is used for quick explosive movements such as sprinting and jumping. So people who perform those powerful actions usually have big and large gastrocnemius muscles. But remember that it also performs knee flexion since it crosses the knee joint. Now when performing knee flexion, if you dorsiflex your foot, it can help increase knee flexion capability. So when remembering the action of the gastrocnemius, just think of the first three letters, gas. When you step on the gas pedal of your car, your foot is plantar, as in plantar flexion. And since you're seated, your knee is also in flexion. This will help you recall the two actions of the muscles. Gas, gastrocnemius. The main synergies are the soleus, plantaris, tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, and they help with plantar flexion. But you also have the hamstring muscles that assist with flexion of the knee, semitendinosus, semimembranosus, and bicep femoris. What is the main antagonist of the gastrocnemius? The tibialis anterior muscle is the main antagonist since it performs dorsiflexion, which is the opposite of plantar flexion. Can you name the main synergies of the gastrocnemius? The soleus, plantaris, tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, and the hamstring muscle group. Can you name the main antagonist of the gastrocnemius? The tibialis anterior muscle. The nerve that innervates the muscle is the tibial nerve from sciatic root S1 and S2. The artery of the gastrocnemius is the sural arteries. Now, can you name the nerve that innervates the gastrocnemius? The tibial nerve from the sciatic nerve root S1 and S2. What is the artery that brings blood to the gastrocnemius? The sural arteries. We can think of the gastrocnemius as a powerful plantar flexor muscle to help you recall the information we learned. But don't forget that it also performs flexion of the knee. Let's quickly recap what we learned today. In what compartment is the muscle located? the superficial posterior compartment. Can you name the other muscle in the compartment? The soleus and plantaris. Now, where does it originate? Where does the gastrocnemius originate? The medial head originates in the medial condyle of the femur. The lateral head originates in the lateral condyle of the femur. Where does it insert? Mid-posterior calcaneus via the Achilles tendon. What are the main actions of the muscle? Plantar flexion and knee flexion. Can you name the main synergists? The soleus, plantaris, tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, and the hamstring muscle group. Can you name the main antagonist muscle? The tibialis anterior muscle. What is the nerve? The gastrocnemius, tibial nerve from sciatic nerve root S1 and S2. What is the artery that provides blood to the muscle? The sural artery. Just think of the gastrocnemius muscle as the powerful plantar flexor muscle to help you recall the information we learn. Okay, I think you guys got it. Thanks for joining me. And don't forget to join me next time as we continue our series on human muscle anatomy of the lower leg. Have a great day.